I was in those moments that you know, take pride in being put in, and yet I let the team down.
Michael and the Bulls would never recover from his struggles in Game 1.
Boy, Michael's missed a lot of close-in shots, and he's tried to take the game off.
As Chicago was eliminated by the Magic, Jordan discovered that his unique ability to lift his team to victory was only a memory. And now, he was left to wonder whether he would ever recapture his former throne.
Give him credit, he's probably still the greatest player in the game overall. But he wasn't his old self.
I was very demoralized, I think. And I was really looking in the mirror the whole time. I had doubts that maybe I can't play the same type of game that I used to play because I wasn't able to do it on call. So in sitting in that locker room, very disappointed, I made a promise to myself that come next year, I'll be ready for this game.
Rededicating himself to the game, Jordan attacked his workouts with a vengeance. And he spent the summer honing his talent like never before.
I felt compelled each and every day when I got up to go out and somehow tune up and get back to where I was. So I was that much more motivated to prove to the world that don't write me off yet.
As he joined his teammates for the 96 season, Michael was embarking not just on a personal quest, but also on an historic mission.
I said to Mike, it's a great challenge anyway, because no one's come back and helped the team win a championship. So this is a great challenge in that regard.
I was being judged on that from the public, from the media, because of my age and because of my being away from the game for 2 years almost. And the only way that I could prove them wrong was to win a championship, you know, from start to finish.
And from the beginning, he was ready to prove his point.
Michael looking to make a move here. Clear out from Longley and picks up with authority.
Wham! In your face.
MJ between them all. He got every one of them.
Yes.
Jordan picked it off. Behind the back. Oh, yes, sir. Wow.
He's in his own little zone today. And it was good.
Three on the shot clock. Here comes Michael. Puts it on the floor. Pull up 16-footer. Put two more down for the King. He is the man.
Here is Jordan. Tonight is showing the entire repertoire.
With Michael on our side, it was, you know, guys were on the bench the whole game saying, oh, we're only 12 now, you know, we're going to come back.
Jordan going and throws it up. There's Giddy, puts it in on an amazing move.
This guy was back in his full force as the most dominant player in the game.
Not only had his dominance returned, so had his zest for the game.
I'll give you a jump shot right now. I'll give you a jump shot. Shoot it. You don't want it. Hey, my boy don't want to play through it. He's hurting this boy. You're hurting it, y'all. Get your back. Get your back. Oh, I got it. Oh. Get my elbow.
His comeback had turned into a joyride as Michael would regain the MVP award and lead the Bulls into NBA history with a record for regular season victories.
There it is! 70 has become a reality for the Chicago Bulls!
Leading the Bulls to an astounding 72 wins, Jordan stamped them as one of the greatest teams ever, and incredibly, raised his own stature even higher.
He was up at the very top, the most popular athlete in the world for 8, 9, 10 years. He leaves the game and comes back stronger than ever. I don't think anyone in the history of sport has ever pulled off something like that, and the guy, and he did it again somehow.
In the playoffs, Michael would come full circle. Again facing Orlando, he would seize the opportunity for redemption.
Michael took it away. He's got Scotty with him.
Erasing the memory of last year's defeat, the Bulls swept the Magic in the Eastern Conference Finals. Jordan was now on the verge of completing his quest.
The Bulls once again make it to the NBA Finals.
and facing the Seattle Supersonics on the NBA's ultimate stage, he would remove any remaining doubts that he was the Michael Jordan of old.
Michael Jordan is in another time, in another space, on another plateau.
And as he led Chicago to victory over Seattle, Michael's comeback was now complete.
And for the fourth time in 6 years, Jordan rules. After a two-year absence, the Chicago Bulls have regained the NBA throne.
It marked the culmination of a journey that had begun with his retirement. Fittingly and symbolically, it had ended on Father's Day.
I think it was a signal to some degree that he was there with me. It was a certain emotions that I couldn't really control, knowing that, you know, the success of it was had something to do with him, you know, and that meant a lot to me.
Michael, I know that the first one was sweet, but how much sweeter was this one?
Well, you know, this, I can't even put it in words. My father said what it means to me. I know he's watching. This is my daddy.
God-given abilities, and then his own self-drive to make him even better than that is something that takes him off the scale.
He is the most tenacious competitor. Add that to his physical gifts, and he has a sense of history and a sense of what his legacy can be if he keeps pushing it.
Michael on the drive. Beautiful! Right by everybody with the left hand.
There's something compelling about this guy, so likable. So dignified and classy, and yet with the athletic heart of an assassin.
Tell me I can no longer fly. I don't want you to.
It's not how hard you push along the way. It's having something in you to finish.
Michael Jordan had regained his place as the NBA's preeminent player. He had recaptured the title and achieved one of sport's greatest comebacks. But as usual, he was intent on achieving even more.
Jordan setting it up on Jamie. Just away. Oh! Taken 51 for Michael Jordan.
MJ.
Oh, he did it! Oh, Michael shakes the finger. He finally got his dunk on Mount Matumbo.
And against the Utah Jazz in the finals, he continued to display the many different ways he could lead a team.
MJ, top of the circle, against Russell. Michael hangs, fires, scores! Knocked it in, Bozeman! He knocked it in at the buzzer, Bozeman! How many times has he done that?
Following his Game 1 heroics, Jordan would provide a different kind of drama in Game 5. Weakened by a stomach virus, he would keep the Bulls in the game through sheer will and determination.
As a leader, you want to be there for your team. As long as I'm able to walk and run and shoot, I've always been there. Sick, you know, it didn't matter.
With the score tied in the final minute, an exhausted Jordan would summon his strength and deliver the crushing blow.
Back, Michael. Open three. Yes! They lead it! 38 points for the Kings!
Stuck a dagger at him with a three!
Yes!
That he gave his day was unbelievable, you know, and his teammates, we really appreciate the way that he's...